So I'm saying for DFS algorithm, in case I visited node A, I go to visit its adjacent node B. Now, unlike BFS algorithm, I'm not going to visit the other adjacent node of A, which is D. Instead, now I move on with my current node. I will now visit the node adjacent to B, which is only C. An unvisited node, which is adjacent to B, is C. Now I go to any node which is adjacent to C. Supposedly from C, I go to E. And from E, I'm going to D. After D, there is no node which is left unvisited. There is no node which is left unvisited. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
After, then I go back to the earlier traversal. Is there any other node adjacent to E which is untraversed? No. Then I again go back. Is there any other node adjacent to C which is untraversed? No. I again go back. And in a similar manner, I keep on doing the process till I reach the node A. So the scheme of coloring changes here. If I see them with coloring scheme.
We could have chosen A se hum D mein bhi to aa sakte
hain. A se D mein bhi aa sakte hain. Since both are adjacent, I can visit any node first. It is one and the same thing. This is a random selection. That happens in BFS also. BFS mein, in case you are doing a BFS, you visit after A, if you visit B, then you will be visiting D before any other node. Or if you visit D, then you will be visiting B. Pehle A ke adjacents you will be covering. After that, B ke adjacents, supposedly C you are covering. After that, D ke adjacents you will be covering. Understanding? This is the BFS. Although in depth first search, you go from one node to another, to another, to another, till there is any adjacent. Now you are reaching A, B, C, D. D has no adjacent node which is not visited yet. So we go back to E, again check it. There is no unvisited node. Go back to C, again check it. Go back to B, again check it. Go back to A, again check it. This is the depth first search algorithm. I do not finish the adjacency list at a time. I only go to one of the adjacent nodes, keep on continuing that process until I have a node which does not have any adjacent node. Since D ka koi adjacent node unvisited nahi hai, the previous node, I go back there. I check whether there is any adjacent unvisited node left. If yes, I would have gone to that node. Otherwise, again, I go back and similarly, I complete my process. Is the process clear to all? I'll just take an example. It might clear up things for you. Now, coloring process, which I'll just be showing you with the algorithm and timing and whatever we are saving here, we are taking two times here. One is a discovery time, another is a finish time. Initially, supposedly, all the nodes are white. I visit a node A, which I color as gray. Whenever I'm coloring a node gray, that marks its discovery time. Initially, if time is 0, then discovery time of A becomes 0 plus 1, that is 1. Fine. From A, I move to node B. Generally, discovery time is represented by 1 slash the finish time. So 1 is the discovery time of A. Now from A, I'm going to B. B is also white. Now please see, A is currently gray only. So I go to B. B is also white. I discover the node B at time 2. And I again, B turns gray. A happens, B happens. Fine. Discovery time of B becomes discovery time of A plus 1, which becomes 2. Right? After that, I go to node C. Again, C is an unvisited node. I color it gray. Discovery time becomes 3. Similarly, I go to E. Again, a white node. Color it gray. Discovery time becomes 4. Finally, go to D. Color that also gray. And discovery time becomes 5. Till here, anybody, any doubt? After I reach D, there is no other node left adjacent node of D, which is white in color. So now finish time of D becomes whatever the current time is plus 1. That means 6 becomes the finish time. And now I colored the node black. Ab jab finish time hoga, then I am coloring the node black. When there is no adjacent node left which has not been visited. Then from D, I go back to E. That is why I am using a stack. Last in, first out. D was last in. Sabse pehle uske nodes check hue. I remove it from the stack. I move on to the next on the stack, which is my E. Now the finish time of E becomes 6 plus 1, which is 7. And now I color this also black since there is no other adjacent node of E which is still unvisited. Similarly, I go to C, finish time becomes 8, and I color this black. Go to B, finish time is 9, color this black. Go to A, finish time becomes 10, color this black. There is no other unvisited node in the graph. I finish my traversal. Is this clear to all?
Mom, isko reverse traverse kyun kiya?
Reversed. I am not doing reverse traversal. Supposedly, there was another node from C which is F. अगर हम C से E पे चले गए थे तो F was undiscovered. So I am going from C to E, E to D. When I come from D to E, I come from E to C. Then I again check कि C का कोई adjacent node तो नहीं रह गया. In case it is left, then F would have been discovered at time 8. Since there is no other adjacent node, it would have been finished at time 9 and C would have been finished at time 10. Understanding? Are you all getting this? I am not doing any backward traversal. Ye samajh aa raha hai sabko? Yes, no, please.
Can you repeat this once?
Yes, ma'am.
I'll give another example. Let me first give you the algorithm. I'll give you all another example. Just have a look at the algorithm. If the screen is visible to all of you, I'm only having a DFS on my graph. For each vertex U, which is belonging to the graph, I am coloring all the vertices white and I am making the parent of all the vertices as nil. Initial start time is 0. And for each vertex, if color is white, then I call DFS visit on that vertex, which is white. Understood? Till here, understood?
Yes, ma'am.
Now, yes, what am I doing in the DFS visit procedure? Since I'm visiting the node, I'll be coloring it gray. I add time to, I increment the time and I make discovery time to be is equal to the incremented time. After that, for each adjacent vertex, if the color is white, then parent of that vertex becomes U. And I call DFS visit on that vertex. And I continue doing this for each adjacent vertex. But DFS visit will be called in a manner so that I reach the end first. Are you all understanding this part? Recursively, I am calling this and recursive calls are handled using stack. Are you all able to understand this? We'll understand. No. So what is happening is initially A ke liye call hua DFS visit hamare example mein. After calling it for A, discovery time 1, V is any adjacent node to A. Supposedly it was B. Since B is white, parent of B becomes A. I call DFS visit for B. Yahan tak theek hai? Is DFS visit mein se abhi hum bahar nahi aaye A ki visit mein se. From that, we are again calling DFS visit for B. Again, it will be called B is gray. Time, discovery time increases. B adjacent node ke liye DFS visit is again called. Till I reach D. After that, I come back. I color the node black. If all the adjacent nodes have been covered only then. Then finish time is updated. Iske baad I come back from the innermost call to the DFS visit, which would be for D. Then I go back here for E, again check, again update, again come back. for DFS visit for C. Again check, come back. DFS visit for B, again check, come back. DFS visit finally for A. After that, its color turns black and the finish time is updated. Now, are you able to understand it? No, yes, no, no. Class, reply.
Ma'am, ek aur example ke saath samjha do.
Ek aur example. I'll just take example, another example. Now, supposedly, this time I'll take an example. The second sheet which I've already sent to all of you. That is the same example that I'm taking over here. Now, for the second example, which I am taking, what is happening in this case is, I have, say, a node U, a node V, and this is, say, a directed graph. I am having a node X. There is an edge from X to V, an edge from Y to X, and I have an edge from W to Y and an edge from W to Z, which has a self loop also. So this is supposedly my some given graph. So initially, if I'm beginning with any random node, supposedly I'm beginning with U. So for that, I call DFS visit on this particular node U. Is this clear? Pehli call. ये सबको क्लियर है?
Yes, ma'am.
First call होते ही what happens? U becomes gray. Time increases and the start time of U or discovery time of U becomes 1. Clear? Yes, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Now I see for all, I run the loop for all the nodes which are adjacent to U. So say for first node I'm coming, I could either go to X or go to V. Any node I can go. Supposedly I go to V. So I will be calling, what I do is, if I am calling V, if you just see the algorithm, if color of V is white, then I make the parent of V as U. Right? Parent of V becomes U. And I call DFS visit on V. Yes or no? Yes, please go ahead. Ask.
Ma'am, ye graph hai, so we have to convert this graph into a tree first.
No, I'm not converting this to tree. Am I?
So, ma'am, parent ka fir kaise pata chalega?
पेरेंट फॉर मी हेयर इज ओनली रिप्रेजेंटिंग कि मैं कहां से वी पे पहुंची हूं. आई कैन रीच वी फ्रॉम सो मेनी प्लेसेस, पर डीएफएस ट्रैवर्सल में फ्रॉम वेयर एम आई रीचिंग द नोड वी, ताकि मुझे पाथ पता हो. फॉर नोइंग द पाथ फ्रॉम यू टू वाई, आई नीड टू नो द पेरेंट्स ऑफ द इन बिटवीन नोड्स ना. दैट इज ट्रैवर्सल में आई एम सेविंग द पेरेंट विद द ओनली पर्पज ऑफ हैविंग अ पाथ. Since I'm reaching V from U, U के adjacent node V है जो कि अभी भी white है जो traverse हो रहा है, that is why parent of V becomes U. Is that clear? Yes, no?
Yes, ma'am.
I am reaching V from U, that is why parent of V becomes U. After that, I call DFS visit again. अब DFS visit जब दोबारा call होगी, I color V as gray. I change time from 1 to 1 plus 1, which becomes the discovery time as 2. Is it clear to all till here? After this is done, I check any adjacent node of V which is still white. There is no edge going out from V, so there is no adjacent node of V. Right? Yes, no?
Yes, ma'am.
Since there is no adjacent node, I come out the loop with checks node. After that, finish time becomes current time plus 1 and time also increments. So this becomes 3 and time also becomes 3. And now I color this node black. This has completely been visited. Is that clear? Till here, any doubt? Anybody, any doubt till here? After this, I come out from DFS visit V. I am still in DFS visit U, but DFS visit V is now over since there was no adjacent node of V, right? So I come back in the loop where I was checking the adjacent of U. Is there any other adjacent of U which is still white? Is there any other node adjacent to U which is still white?
Yes, ma'am.
X is there. That means what I do is parent of X becomes U, and I call DFS visit for X. Is this clear to all? Say yes or no, please.
Yes, ma'am.
Now, since I am reaching from here, now X becomes gray. Discovery time and time becomes 4. And I again check, is there any other node adjacent to X which is white? There is only one node adjacent to X, which is V, which is already black. It is not white. So there is no other node left which is adjacent to X and which is white. Is that clear? In case, supposedly, just for example, if I am taking this edge to be in the opposite direction, in that case, there was a node which is adjacent to X, which is still white, which is Y? Yes or no?
Yes
or no?
Yes, ma'am.
You all are there with me, right? In that case, what will happen? Parent of Y becomes X, and I call DFS visit for Y. Is this clear to all? When DFS visit for Y is called, Y turns gray, time increments and the discovery time of Y becomes 5. Clear? I again check, is there any other adjacent node of Y which is still white? There is no other adjacent node of Y which is white. There is no adjacent node of Y, only there is no outgoing edge. Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
That means Y will be coming out from the adjacency loop. After that, finish time will be the time increment 1, becomes the finish time, and I will be coloring the node black. This is finished. That means DFS visit Y is over. After DFS visit Y is over, I go back to DFS visit X. I still check if there is any other node of X which is still adjacent and black. Oh, sorry, white. There is no other node of X which is still white? Yes, no? There is no node of X which is still white. That means I update the finish time to be current time plus 1, which becomes 7, and I colored the node black. That means now I am coming out from this DFS visit X. After coming from here, I again go back to DFS visit of U. Now, DFS visit of U may, I again check, is there any node adjacent to U which is still left white? There is no node adjacent to U which is still left white. That means time increments by 1, it gets 8, and that is the finish time of node U, and U turns black. And I come out from DFS visit U. Is that correct? Yes or no?
Yes, ma'am.
Now I go back to DFS G. There were two functions, if you recall. DFS visit for U se bahar aaye, DFS G mein gaye. Wahan pe it will again check. It was running a loop for all the nodes, and it is calling DFS visit for any node that is white. Since these 4 nodes are black, DFS visit will not be called on them. Supposedly, I call DFS visit on W. In that case, the discovery time of W becomes time plus 1. That means 9. I turn W gray. After turning W gray, I again check if any adjacent node is still white. That is Z. Yes, I call DFS visit Z. Again, I turn the node gray. Increase